nappy headed, ugly black motherfucker. Now, if you look like me, you probably heard a phrase like that when you were younger. First time you heard that phrase, it probably hurt your feelings. The 10th or 20th time you heard that phrase, probably not so much. Because by the 20th time you've heard that phrase, you'd owned it, you'd embraced it, you understand that was your reality. And probably somebody you knew had been called ugly black motherfucker. Or you when you and your friends were sitting around fucking around teasing each other, you'd maybe call somebody ugly black motherfucker. And you resign yourself to whatever comfort level can be gained being a nappy-headed, ugly black motherfucker. Didn't mean that much to you. Here's the thing. Long after you stopped hearing that out loud, because that doesn't go on forever. You know, it might be for elementary school, middle school, maybe a little middle school. By high school, that's done. You know, that's done. Depending on your age generation. You know, in my generation, maybe it lasts a little bit in high school. But by, I don't know, 10th, 11th grade, ain't nobody fucking around like that. But here's the thing that's really a trick bag about that. Long after you stopped hearing that out loud, you were hearing that inside. You were saying that. That was your reality that you accepted. Now, maybe you got lucky, and not even lucky. I'm sorry I even said the word lucky. You know, life took on its natural course. You dated this girl. You dated that girl. You dated some sisters. You dated some white girls. You dated whatever you dated. You dated whatever. But here's the thing. Here's the thing that changes over. One day, one of the beautiful people walks up to you and says, you know, you're really cute, or I think you're really handsome, or you're attractive, and you're confused because you'd been resigned and comfortable with ugly black motherfucker, and now she ain't come with this bullshit. So you think she's trying to play you. So you move on. Now here's the thing. The other day, I'm in the gym, and a woman comes up to me, and she's checking me out, but I don't think that's what it is. I'm thinking to myself, why is she looking at me? My shoelaces untied? I got a booger in my nose? There's something on my shirt? You know, this is where my head is at. Because, and that's where the shock had come over me that I thought that I had put that aside long ago. But it turns out I was still carrying that little chocolate monster around. Still today. It comes up in times or moments of weakness or when you're not paying attention, feeling good about yourself. Instead of you just being proud and happy that you are the beautiful black man, you are the beautiful black specimen that you are. And it occurs to me if I was feeling this way, if any moment I might feel this way, then anybody could feel that way. And not just the ugly black nappy-headed motherfuckers like me. But maybe that freckle-faced redhead or that pasty-faced toe-head white boy or that big nose jewel or that greasy head or whatever the fuck. Because it doesn't really matter if it's black or it's white or it's redhead or it's only, everybody's got their thing. Everybody's got their thing that people tease them about or say about them. And it made me understand the nature of insecurity. You don't really grow up being insecure. You don't just decide to be insecure. That's something that somebody gives to you, and then you run with it. You keep it. So here's what I'm saying. I thought I put it down a long time ago, but knowing that I was still carrying that around in my pocket, I pulled it out and threw it on the floor. Put that down. There is no ugly black motherfuckers or ugly redhead or whatever. If you think that, if you believe that based on your own opinion, then I guess it's true. But if you don't believe that, no one else will. Understand that. People believe about you what you believe about yourself, not what you think about yourself, not what you hope about yourself, but what you believe about yourself. Believe yourself to be beautiful. If you look in the mirror and you are happy with what you see, if your reflection does not revolt you, it won't repel anybody else. Chances are you're probably a lot better looking than you think you are. So let go of those insecurities. There's always going to be someone taller, shorter, more muscular, greener, bluer, browner eyes, whatever the fuck. There's always something else, something more. More often than not, you may think the grass is greener. Sometimes the grass is greener because the grass ain't real. Be happy with what you're carrying around. You're not going to get nothing else. Whatever your standard issue is, there ain't going to be no more options. Whatever your standard issue, that's all you got. That's all you get.